So on Prometheus, Wayman Corporation, the end credits, we didn't see this, but we did read it. The end credits is raising up a whole lot of speculation. And it's something to where it's a registered trademark, but it's dated to be official like on October 11th of 2012. And it's spooking out and creating some hype, some false hype. And it's not to say that there's nothing behind this, because there obviously is. They've invested money in making this movie. They've made a really nice looking website, and it's interesting, and I'm sure it scares and spooks and frightens many, because it is set up in such a way that it makes it like if the change of the world is gonna be real, and it's gonna be through this and that. And they have applications and information and stuff about what ones could do to participate in this. And so yeah, there is definitely something behind this. And let us not forget that the wicked plan a day of wrath against the day of wrath. So, definitely something to look out for. And plus, regardless of whether the situation be small or big, the matter being tiny or huge, we are to be watching out for each other, and we need to be we need to have that heads up on what the enemy is up to and what they're contemplating. We need to be on that, and we need to be informing each other. That's why we give thanks to the brother that was kind enough to let us know what was going on as far as that. And we suggest that more of us following that example. Not only will it build a relationship and a friendship, but it'll keep us alert and active and ready for anything that is to come, because many are planning a day of wrath against the day of wrath. But let us go on forward, where movement it cannot be impeded or obstructed, by knowing that these ideas are vain in their imagination, and only the word of God has proven time after time and eternity after eternity and then some, and even more than them, and even more than them. Only Jah word is true. And so we know it, that the only power is in our Father, and all authority and dominion has been given to his Son Yeshua. And so let us not be scared or fall victims to what we Rastafari do not even recognize. And that is what that is what some we don't know what to call them, but they regard to it as fear. And we don't know that. We have not been given a spirit of fear. As a matter of fact, we don't know what we're even saying. So let us just let us include some true wisdom. Once again, give thanks to the brother. And also, we need to be communicating like that, and wisdom will shine better light why that is. But first, we make mention that we need to be independent, not be depending on them. We need to provide each other with the knowledge and their knowledge necessary to go on forth and do that which we are to do. And it's like, what we're saying is we're trying to ask ones to follow in the footsteps of what our brother has initiated. And what we mean is the individual that gave us the heads up on the whole Prometheus situation, the whole Prometheus theatrical means to manipulation. Without that heads up, honestly, I would have never had any idea of what that even was. We still kind of don't, but now we looked into it enough to disprove it and discredit it and abandon any such rise of nonsense. But let us read here. Let the wise mind of His Majesty do the talking. We did not do justice to that. It is a sound tactic of military strategy to attack where your opponent's defense is weakest. It is surely sound strategy for all of us to move ahead where such movement is unobstructed and unimpeded. If you're spiritually weak, don't watch these movies. Let's move on ahead where we are not captivated and fascinated and therefore become fascist and possessed and bewitched, and we lose all ability to perceive, you know, and to receive, because we're frozen spiritually and psychologically. Let us move on ahead. Let us, you know, because a tactic is only a small little plan within a strategy. So we know who's the best strategist, and that is the Almighty Creator, because he staged all of this. But the wicked them, you know, having free will and stuff, and using their free will and exercising their free will to the most evil of their capability. At least they, we could give them that. They're exercising their free will, and that is what I and I Rastafari must practice and come together in communication and in such ways, you know, acting as one body in Christ. Now, a nation cannot prosper unless it has overcome the problems of communications. Without communications, agriculture cannot develop, nor can commerce or industry thrive. It is communication that relates and binds people together by ties of friendship. Now, that is why, once more, we honor the brother that gave the heads up, and we give thanks, because all of this is coming from one small spark that lit the fuse. Who knows what might light that fuse, right? And in this case, it was a brother. And we'll go on to make mention. If we act where we may, in those areas where action is possible, it's a brother acting. In those areas where action is possible, the inner logic of the programs which we adopt will work for us and inevitably impel us still farther in the direction of ultimate union. You know, we give thanks and praises in this case to God our Father, His Imperial Majesty, Haile Selassie I, the elect of God, King of Kings, conquering lion of the tribe of Judah, Emperor of Ethiopia, and His Christ, Yeshua HaMashiach, the Son of God, came in the Ethiopian flesh and caused a great disappointment among the darkened hearted and the wicked them, right? But yeah, so let us on. You know, we can't say much about that. But okay, let us make mention that in the summit speech, or forgive I for not recalling the exact title, but in the 1963 address to the League of Nations, New York, October 7th, I believe, 6th or 7th, His Majesty goes on to mention that we must put our faith in the Almighty Creator that is good. You know, He will not disappoint us. And also makes mention He makes mention how He will not allow the mankind to destroy himself, mankind that He's created in His image. And that is interesting, because and it's not that we're trying to add or subtract from it, but he never mentions, His Majesty, we mean, never mentions that He will not allow the wicked them to destroy themselves. He clearly mentions mankind, which God has created in His image. So it's not to say that anything that is not in the image of the Almighty, that is good, is to survive. So that is interesting, and we must bring to context or make mention to better comprehend that He was speaking to the leaders of the world. And He also mentioned, you know, you got to remember that your fate is not entirely in your hands. And so putting that together, it's for the wicked to be alarmed, and for us to keep in faith. We walk it by faith, you know. So also it makes mention that the basis of discrimination and colonialism has been strictly economical, and it is with economic weapons that it has been, can be, and will always be destroyed. So let us go on forth to make mention that the investment on Prometheus Wayman Corporation has been economical. It's in the media, it's a movie, you know, it's trying to sell tickets. Let us not fall victims to this. Let us not supply them with our economics, you know, but let us not overlook that we must be aware of these such things and be on it. You know, we got to know it all. We got to seek a spiritual knowledge and a secular knowledge as well. Now, are we forgetting something? No. Okay, let us continue. Now we could go on forth to determine why we can be in so comfortable. You see, Yeshua is that day of wrath where the revelation of righteous judgment of God is revealed. That's Yeshua. Everything that's written, he is everything that's written. Before him, nothing was written, and nothing was the world, the earth was without form and void. So he brings form to everything. So, you know, Yeshua is the word. It's like, let me just read this. Writing with reference to form of letters, information, that's Yeshua. This whole book, the scripture is writing in reference to a form of letters, and that is Yeshua. From A to Z, from Alpha to Omega, from Ha to Pe, you know, from, I forgot the Hebrew, what is it, from Aleph to Tau. So you know, it's all Jesus Christos, and so everything that's been written is true. But the ideas of man are vain in imagination, and we learn that they promise, change, but we must rely and put our hope and our faith in the Almighty, and he will not disappoint us. Now, continuing, express in written characters, that's Yeshua, expressed, and let us take on those characters. Record. We gotta record this. We gotta show penmanship. Compose. To draw up. Outline. Yeshua fills in that outline. There was an outline in the Old Testament. Now, Yeshua HaMashiach, he fills it up. It was an empty cup, now filled. He fulfills the law. He is righteousness. He is justice. And, you know, interest, and these are all kind of definitions that come out of the word, we believe it was grapho, which was the express image, and, you know, we kind of lost reference, but some other, words that we looked up, but as far as expressed image, in the New Testament, book of Hebrews, one of the definitions, one of the root words, is a pale, a stake, and that is in fact kind of describing how like carving or chipping away into stone, you know, and so a stake would be like Fred Flintstone when he uses to carve out the law, and so what it's signifying is not only the rock, you know, carving the law into the rock and forming Iandai, but the formation, the information with reference to form being Yeshua HaMashiach. And then also unseen, secret. Now this is going into darkness. Why we've been speaking of darkness. You see, we're going into a time of darkness where the wicked get to exercise their wickedness. Nonetheless, we are not in darkness. Yeshua is our light. So those things unseen, the secret things are revealed to I and I, and we must walk that walk so that we must shine light upon them that lack daylight and are ignorant of all divine things. So yeah, and some of the other videos kind of explained what the pales do. They hold everything together. And yeah, so let us go into scripture, because it's the most important reference that we have. So, you know, we're going into less light, more darkness, but let our hearts be light as feathers. You know, let us enjoy the comfort of the Holy Spirit, knowing that all will be good. The world could be flipped upside down, and we've shown how that is. And, you know, we gotta, you know, what is life that we should fear to lose it? Is life not our creator? Is our life not the light? Is it not Yeshua HaMashiach? Then what are we to fear, you know? So, you know, let us begin with, let's go straight to Psalm 23. Being that I've heard many address this as their favorite psalm. Not to say that we don't favor, you know. We take the scripture equally as important. We might be enjoying one section of scripture at one point in time, but we learn that scripture is beautiful because if you go with the Spirit, then Jah will teach you how everything is equally important, because it all applies to space and time. And okay, let us just make mention, we don't have no evidence for this, but the word is everything. And so if you use the word and if you apply it in space and time correctly, with the will through the Spirit, with the will of the Almighty through the Spirit, you learn that everything is the word. And so, you know, depending on space and time, you're directed to truth, to what is taking place. It's really interesting. We just thought about that, so we can't explain that all that well, but the word is everything. Now, Psalm 23, forgive me for keeping back, but it reads, a Psalm of David. The Lord, Geta is Zion, thy shepherd. I shall not want. Let us not want. That is pure. Not wanting is, okay, let's not get into it, but let us not want. Let us know. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. You know, let us be cool and calm, not heavy hearted. Everything will always be fine. He restored my soul. He leadeth me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. Let us remember that it's not because we are that, you know, what is man that thou art mindful of him, and it's not us really, it's his name's sake. So it's righteousness sake, it's Yeshua, it's our Father's name's sake. And thus, for the same reason, we should be serious about this, because it's not our names that are at stake. It's Yeshua's and our Father's first power of the Trinity. Okay, let us continue. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. We know it not evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, my cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me, and all the days of my life. And I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever, of the house of Geta. Now, and ever, amen, and amen. Let us make mention. Okay, Valley of the Shadows of Death. Shadow, Old Testament. And one second, please. Okay, now a shadow. Shade caused by the interception of light. Light. If we walk in light, we shall cast a shadow. We shall judge a shadow to the lightless, to the dark-hearted. You know, because them thinking them be wise, they'll be proven fools if one is walking in that light and manifesting that light in and through Yeshua. An image cast by an object and representing the form of that object. So an image cast by an object, by an objective maybe. Cast, we know cast could be throwing, and throwing could be judgment. So an image judged by an object representing the form of that object. So we are representing the form. What is the form? The form is the formation, the information, and all is without form unless it is in Yeshua. And so we are the objective to represent that form, and thus casting, judging the image. Kind of, okay, this is kind of confusing, right, to some, but you know, I take full responsibility that it is I that am not able to explain it that well, but an image cast by an object. So we are to represent that image of, in, you know, to be how Jah created us, in his image. So that is what we are to represent, and the form is Yeshua, to make visible that image, and therefore cast judgment upon those that err, that dwell in spiritual death, that are in our umbra, kind of. But you know, some of the other videos, the one with all the pictographs, is really good, because it'll kind of give a visual on how it says here that as I walk in the valley of the shadows of death. It's shadow of death to them that are wicked, but it is life, it is our cover as Rastafari, but it is death to the darkened hearted. And so that in itself is interesting, and it becomes our umbrella, because watch here, preparest a table for in the presence of thou anointed my head with oil, my cup run it over. You see, the depiction shows the waves, so the our sea is cool and calm, and we are in the, you know, we're in a our vessel, we're going into darkness, but the passing over, Jah flips it around, and that cup and the sea and stuff like that becomes an umbrella, our covering, our shade, and all that was in the vessel is poured down, and so that's the coming down of the Spirit, the anointing. That's how, you know, and our cup run it over. So it could be run it over with abundancy of life, or run it over like flipped upside down, and it, no, I think it's having endless springs of water of life more abundantly flowing from my eye. So it's interesting that, you know, really check out if at least for the drawings or pictographs, check out that other video, because it goes into much of what is explained in that psalm. And also we could go to Psalm 144, which is actually, it's Friday, October 5th, and Psalm 144 has to do with Rastafari sabbatical study number 32 and no, not 32, my bad, 52 and 53, and which is approaching. Now, Psalm 144, if we could find that really quick, you know, we'll just leave, okay, well, yeah, let's read it. Blessed be Geta, my strength, which teacheth my hands to war and my fingers to fight. Okay, there's so much to that. But our hands and our, okay, just know that it has to do with penmanship and with the writing, and with the, we are to write a report, we are to testify, we are testifying to Yeshua, and testifying to Yeshua mean that the word is true, and God be true, and he's a man that, God is not a man that would lie, he's not a liar, but he does manifest in man. And so we got to witness and testify and write our reports, and who shall receive or believe our reports, right? But still we should put them out there and testify and write those reports and witness that everything that man be saying, whether it be Prometheus, that movie, or it be the end of the world, or the 2012 Maya theories or predictions and stuff like that, that's all been proven lies, and we can testify to this. So we must bring comfort to those and bring them to Yeshua. so that they may bear fruit of their own. My goodness and my fortress, my high tower and my deliverer, my shield, our protection, basically. And he in whom I trust, that is whom we trust. We don't trust man, we trust the Almighty. He has proven to us without even have to. he's under no obligation to prove to us, yet he does time after time that he is trustworthy, who subdueth my people under me. Geta, what is man that thou takest knowledge of him, or the son of man that thou makest account of him? Man is like to vanity, man is vanity. His days are as a shadow that passeth away. He's like a cloud. You know, it brings a, okay, continuing. Bow thy heavens, O Geta, and come down, touch the mountains, and they shall smoke. Cast forth thy lightning and scatter them, shoot out thy arrows and destroy them. Okay, we're gonna reference that we haven't uploaded it, but so we don't know the title, but it's a video and it's got a lot of drawings. Look for it. It should be right next to this one, but we don't know yet. The whole come down and the come down, touch the mountains and they shall smoke. We were coming from the library and we saw that the mountains, San Diego region mountains, looked red, and there's all kinds of clouds on top, and they looked like smoke. And that's because the sun is coming down. It is we're passing over, right? So the sun is like right on the horizon, and that's what it looked like. Now, many others do not have the truth. They have not seen the truth. Things have not been revealed to them. So they'll just stick to, oh, this is talking about sun worship. Nah, it's like, it's everything. The word is Yeshua. So just like it is in his manifestation as man, it's in all manifestations, because he is the creator and everything else is created. So let us continue. Send thine hand from above, rid me and deliver me out of the great waters. Passover, flip the waters, you know, and pour the word of truth upon us. Pour that spirit on us, we pray thee, Almighty. Now, continuing. Okay, we kind of, from the hand of, okay, out of great waters, from the hand of strange children, whose mouth speak of vanity, they talk. And their right hand is a right hand of falsehood. Need we say more? We think not. We know not. We will sing a new song to thee, O Jah Rastafari, upon a psaltery and an instrument of 10 strings. 5 and 5 equals Asher. That's interesting. 5 and 5 equals 10 equals Asher. But Asher will not save us, you know? And so that has to do with penmanship and the whole commandments and all that. So continuing, it is he that giveth salvation to kings, who delivered David his servant from the hurtful sword. Rid me and deliver me from the hand of strange children, whose mouth speak of vanity, and the right hand is a right hand of falsehood. It's like Babylon is fallen, it's fallen. That verse had to be said twice because their right hand is a hand of falsehood, and we are, you know, the emphasis on this is to show that we are not to feel threatened or fall victims to that which we know not, which some lifeless individuals, if even they are that, consider or acknowledge or regard as fear. We know it, not fear. We have not been given that spirit. What is that? So continuing, it says that our sons may be as plants grown up in their youth. Youth? Okay. That our daughters may be as cornerstones polished after the similitude of a palace. That our garners may be full, affording all manner of store. That our sheep may bring forth thousands and ten thousands. Aleph, no, ilf in the Ethiopic would be innumerable, you know, thousands, ilf, kind of like Aleph. In our streets, that our oxen may be strong to labor, that there be no breaking in nor going out, and there be no complaining in our streets. It's like 120 days. Moses, this day I am 120 years. No longer shall I go in or come out. And then 120 years, it's interesting because somewhere inside of there, it's speaking of one of those words in the Hebraic. It's actually meaning to the sun. And so the whole, there is that connection with the 120 and the 120 years. It, one of the words you would never assume, but if you go word by word and look up the Hebraic reference word for where Moses says, this day I am 120 years, one of those words is saying son, S-O-N. And so, l'chteferi, the 120 years, this time, this point in time, it's like a complete and direct reference to it. We don't have anything prepared for that, but we know it is so. So continuing, happy is that people that is in such a case, yea, happy is that people whose God is Geta Jesus. And that's exactly what is in this week's reading. Let's see if we could find that. Chapter 33 of the book of Deuteronomy, and this is the blessing wherewith Moses, the man of God, blessed the children of Israel before his death. Now, chapter 33, verse 29 of the book of Deuteronomy, it says, happy art thou, O Israel, Israel hoy, who is like to thee, who is like to thee, O people, saved by Geta, Jesus, Yeshua, the shield of thy help, and who is the sword of thy excellency, and thine enemies shall be found liars to thee, and thou shalt tread upon their high places. They got nothing on us. Mountain of Nebo. That's interesting. But yeah, okay, let us include some more of this, because this is good, and we comfort in this personally, and we pray that all the I them do as well. Let us go to, okay, so that we don't go too far off, let us go to Deuteronomy chapter 29, and it reads, and verse 29, and it reads, the secret things that belong to Geta Jesus, our Elohim, our God, but those things which are, okay, let us go from verse 28. We ask for forgiveness, you know, for that mix-up. Chapter 29, book of Deuteronomy, verse 28. And Geta rooted them out of their land in anger and in wrath and in great indignation and cast them into another land, as it is this day, I and I. The secret things belong to Geta, our God, but those things which are revealed belong to us and to our children forever, that we may do all the words of this law, the word, those things that are revealed. We have received a revelation. We know it, that which people have died trying to come to know. Wars have been fought, people have been killed. Many have died, many have studied their whole lives and have not received. How fortunate is this generation that receiveth the revelation of the word, of the only thing that is true. Now, let us add to that. Deuteronomy chapter 32, verse 1. Give ear, O heavens, O ye heavens, and I will speak, and hear, O earth, the words of my mouth. My doctrine shall drop as rain, my speech shall distill as the dew. And we could go on and on and on and on, but it's the, just wanted to emphasize on, give ears, O ye heavens, and I will speak, and hear, O earth, the words of my mouth, calling to witness heaven and earth, high places. We don't know low places, but we are upon earth, but we are in a high in a high place upon earth. Now, give, like, testify, like, that my words will water my plants, and my water will not be in vain. You know, whomever I give my word to shall not lack in fruit. You know, we shall bring forth fruit. So let us bring forth fruit. Let us go to, it's our time to shine. Let us just make mention of that, you know. It's Rastafari time to shine, because Halloween is coming up, Thanksgiving is coming up, Christ Massacre is coming up. Let us walk the walk and shine light upon those lacking daylight. Now, okay. Isaiah. Let us go to Isaiah 55. You know, forgive I, we're trying to do this as quickly as possible. Is it the quickening? Or, nah, we just wanna like, we know we have busy lives, you know, being that Babylon like to have us that way. They don't want us to stop and think. So we know that we're all short on time, and we're trying to go through this fairly rapidly. Now, Isaiah, book of Isaiah, the prophet, chapter 55. Let us go on to okay. Well, let us just okay, verse 6. Seek ye the Lord while he may be found. Call ye upon him while he is near. Let the wicked forsake his way, and the unrighteous man his thoughts, and let him return to Geta, and he will have mercy upon him, and to our God, for he will abundantly pardon. For my thoughts are not your thoughts, neither are your ways my ways, said Geta. For as the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts than your thoughts. Seek a higher spirituality, a higher vibrational state of mind. Emancipate from mental slavery. Free yourself from all death and all low frequency, like low vibrational thinking. You know, we must be in high places. We must try to seek those high thoughts, you know, higher state of mind, to not be affected by all this nonsense. For as the rain cometh down, and the snow from heaven, and returneth not thither, but watereth the earth, and maketh it bring forth and bud, that it may give seed to the sower and bread to the eater. So shall my word be that goeth forth out of my mouth. It shall not return me void, but it shall accomplish that which I please, and it shall prosper in the things whereto I sent it. Amen. Yeah, that's good right there. We were actually seeking this verse, but so let us include that. So, for mine house shall be a house called an house of prayer for all people. Right? But, okay. Verse, this is actually chapter 56. Chapter 56, verse 7. Verse 8. And the Lord God, which gathereth the outcast of Israel, said, Yet will I gather others to him beside those that are gathered to him. All ye beasts of the field come to devour, yea, all ye beasts in the forest. His watchmen are blind. They are all ignorant. They are all dumb dogs. They cannot bark. Sleeping, lying down, loving to slumber. Yea, they are greedy dogs which can never. This was definitely not the scripture we were looking for. Forgive me. It is, in fact, chapter 60. Arise, shine, for thy light is come, and the glory of Geta is risen upon thee, for behold, the darkness shall cover the earth, and gross darkness the people. The Lord shall rise upon thee, and his glory shall be seen upon thee. And the Gentiles shall come to thy light, the kings to the brightness of thy rising. You know? So that is what we've been explaining now. Now, if we, chapter 60 of the book of Isaiah, if we go to verse 14, the sons also of them that afflicted thee shall come bending to thee, and all they that despise thee shall bow themselves down at the soles of thy feet. Everywhere our soul, the soles of our feet trotting, is our under our dominion, authority, in and through Getai Jesus Christus. And they shall call thee the city of the Lord, the Zion of the Holy One of Israel. Now, if we spring over to verse 19, the sun shall be no more light by day, neither for brightness shall the moon give light to thee, but the Lord shall be to thee an everlasting light, and thy God thy glory. The sun shall no more go down, neither shall thy moon withdraw itself, for the Lord shall be thine everlasting light, and the days of thy mourning shall be ended. Thy people also shall be all righteous. They shall inherit the land forever, the branch of my planting, the works of my hand, that I may be glorified. A little one shall become a thousand ilf, and a small one a strong nation. I, the Lord, will hasten it in his time. So we're going to add a few more scriptures in the next presentation. We give thanks to all Rastafari and to all that accompany us, that are lovers of truth, that seek a truth. You know, let Jah be our guidance and protection. Shalom.